quack, quack.
Why that this submarine is as good as it is, I will show you right here. It has 10 missiles, it has 20 torpedoes, and it has 15 noisemakers like any other submarine, and 10 Mark 70 MOS. So again, if you don't know what the Mark 70 MOS does, this is basically a noisemaker, but in a torpedo, so you can fire this in the direction which you're getting shot from. But the thing that makes this submarine as good as it is both the missiles and the torpedoes. It has a lot of decoys. There's other submarines out there which do more damage than this one, but I prefer this because it has way more decoys than the other submarine. I will be going over that submarine in another video though, but this one has 20 torpedoes which do 45% damage on a tier 3 ship each. So you can fight another submarine out there and one torpedo will do 45% damage to him. Now the missiles are very good as well. They are 40% damage to a tier 3 ship. And the noisemakers, of course, and the Mark 70 MOS don't do damage, but those are great for getting away from torpedoes. Now another thing why this Trafalgar is so good is its speed. You can get away or get two targets very easily with 32 knots as a max speed. It's a very good submarine, it handles alright, it's super fast, and it has a big armament as you can see. So that is why I personally prefer the Trafalgar submarine for PvPing. It's a very good one. There is other submarines out there, they do less damage, but they will also get the job done. There's also submarines which do more damage, but yeah, this one might be my go-to submarine for PvP. Now the Trafalgar starts off at 1 million credits, which is really not a lot for a submarine, and it's a great warship, so I suggest you get this if you really want to get into PvP, and it's a very good PvP ship overall. Now that is my reason as to why I think that this is the best PvP submarine. There's also other submarines out there which might benefit your playstyle more, which is perfectly fine, then you can go ahead and play with that. But personally, I would suggest this one because it has a lot of decoys, it has a very good speed, it has a decent amount of damage, and it's very good overall in defense. Now, I really hope that this video helped you guys out. I really hope you enjoyed. Leave a like if you did. And I'll talk to you guys in the next one. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.